Does your Ender 3 look like this, where the filament is cutting into the extruder arm? I'll show you a 3D print that will take care of this and fix your problem right here at Filament Friday. Filament Friday is brought to you every week by the generous donations of these Patreon supporters. My print farm has been taken over. I'm printing clips for the personal protection shields that the 3D printing community is creating and shipping to hospitals. Here's the design that I'm helping support. It's the Prusa designed face shield. I'm printing the lower clips. The upper portion is also 3D printed, but Steve at SeemeCNC created a mold so he can injection mold that top piece, and he's been shipping those out for the cause. With material from Atomic Filament, they've donated a whole bunch of these at no cost to the effort. And Alan at Repkord, famous for the Rep Box, he's leading a team that's putting these all together to make full shields. And what he told me is he needed more clips because they now have enough top pieces, but they needed more clips. And that's where my print farm came in. So I fired up the print farm, I got 8 machines going, and I'm able to print quite a few clips. I just throw them in a box, go to the post office, ship them out to those guys, and every 2 to 3 days, I have another 250 for them. But in the process, one of the new Ender 3s I put into the print farm, it was cutting into the arm. So I wanted to fix this before this thing wore out. Some people put a guide on it, you can find this on Thingiverse, but it's going to wear out as well. Some say just reprint it, but I wanted to fix the problem, not just band-aid it. On another machine, I have an EZR extruder, and it's starting to wear a little bit, even though the plastic's a lot stronger. On a third one with an EZR, I actually drilled it out and put a piece of PTFE tubing in it. This seemed to have helped quite a bit. Now you say I could just use a metal extruder. Well, I've been testing this dual gear, and look at this. Even with grease and everything on it, this thing's grinding away. I'm going to run this to see how long it lasts. There is a metal version of that original extruder. I've shown this in a previous video. It seems to work really well. I just don't have another one. So I want to fix this and just not have to tear the machine apart. So what I decided to do is just put my side spool holder on it. I showed this over a year ago. I still believe this is the best way to go. It makes the machine a little wider, but it's worth it. So I design it in Tinkercad, and then I bring it into Cura, print it at a 0.2 layer height with a 50% infill. That way it's pretty strong, and this thing will slide right on a rail, and you can mount the spool holder right to it, the existing spool holder. And then the spool is on the side. I do share this file on Thingiverse. It's called the Ender 3 Side Spool Converter Bracket. And you can see this thing has been up there for over a year. I use it all the time. It's worked out really well. But if you want the source file, I share that at mychepclub.com under the file section. Now you do have to be a Patreon supporter to access this. $1 a month is all it takes. But then you get access to the Tinkercad source file, so you can modify it however you want. I printed out the bracket, and then I could remove the spool holder. And the spool holder, you just take the T-nuts off, and they slide right into the slots of the 3D print, and then the holes line right up. So then you just mount the original spool holder through the screws to the 3D printed bracket, and then tighten everything up so it's one solid unit. So just tighten both screws so it's nice and solid, and now we can slide this onto the rail. You pop the end cap off, and then we can slide this to the back of the printer. So keep the wires underneath it, and then slide the bracket onto the 3D printer, and then put the cap back on, and you can slide this and adjust it to where you want. So the spool lines up, and then you just slip the spool in, feed the filament into the extruder, and then all the way into your nozzle. And this thing should be ready to go. It's strong enough, it's going to hold the spool, and it should work well. Here it is, back in business, printing clips. Now some say this is too wide, it makes the printer too wide. I've had that on my bench. I turn them 45 degrees so they angle behind each other. That works out really well. As you can see, the filament is now going below that notch. It's going straight into the hole. Eventually I'll fix this and replace that arm. But for right now, problem solved. If you're interested in helping and printing more clips, I'll put all the information in the description below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time right here at Filament Friday.